Welcome to Communication Engineering playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain communication systems block diagram. So basically, in entire communication system, how many functions that is happening at transmitter side as well as receiver side. So all those details that I'll be going to discuss step by step. So if you see the block diagram of communication system, then we'll be having input signal, that is message signal, that first we will be giving it to input transducer, then after it will be going to transmitter block, then we send that signal into channel, then after passing through channel that signal will get received at receiver, and during propagation in channel there will be few noise as well as distortion that will get added, and then receiver signal, receiver block, that will translate that received signal to manageable signal, and that it will be given to output transducer, and then again we'll be having output signal, which is what information signal that we are sending at input side. So during that complete process there are various blocks, so those blocks I'll be discussing step by step, one by one. So here first thing is input signal. That input signal could be voice signal, it could be text signal, it could be speech signal, it could be video signal. So here we'll be having input signal. That input signal, that could be text signal, voice signal, it could be video signal. So there could be any out of those signals which is there as input signal. Even that signal would be electrical signal. Now then after there will be immediate block, that will be input transducer. So now what is the function of input transducer? Now as I have told, there could be text signal, voice signal, video signal, image signal. So out of those signals could be there at input side. Now all those signals, these are not electrical signals. So immediate block, that will be input transducer. Now what is the function of this input transducer? So this input transducer, that will convert electrical signal from non-electrical signal. So this input transducer, that will be converting non-electrical signal into electrical signal. So it converts non-electrical signal into electrical signal. Let us have one example. Like if I have voice signal, then our input transducer will be microphone. So that will be converting voice signal into electrical signal. So for voice, we can use microphone. So likewise, there are different transducer which is available that will be in use to translate non-electrical signal into electrical signal. So now we'll be having electrical signal over here. Now, whatever electrical signal that is available over here, that will be low frequency signal as well as low power signal. So this electrical signal is having characteristic, that is low frequency signal and low energy signal. So this is what the signal which is there at output side of transducer. So there will be immediate block, that is transmitter block. Now what is that which is there with transmitter block? So transmitter block is having amplifier, it is having modulator. So what will happen is modulator will translate low frequency signal into high frequency signal, and amplifier will amplify low energy signal into high energy signal. So in transmitter block, there will be amplifier, there will be modulator, there will be filter, there could be mixer, there could be antenna. So these are the elements which will be there in transmitter block. Now antenna is being used to send signal in wireless channel. So here these are the various elements that will be there in transmitter block. So after transmitter block we'll be having electrical signal that will be, now if you have antenna, then now that electrical signal will be electromagnetic wave, and that will be having characteristic like high frequency and high energy. So ultimately this transmitter block that translates low frequency low energy signal into high frequency high energy signal. And once you translate that into high frequency high energy signal, we can send that signal to longer distance in channel. Now when we talk about channel, there could be wired channel or wireless channel. So there could be wireless channel or there could be wired channel. For wireless channel, transmitter block is having antenna, and for wired channel there could be optical cable, there could be copper cable, there could be coaxial cable. So there are various cable which is available for wire channel. Now when this signal is traveling through channel, noise and distortion that will get added in channel. So after traveling to longer distance, what will be the property of signal which is received at receiver block? So that signal will be EM wave. In case of wireless channel, it could be electrical signal in case of wired channel. But what are the properties? Those properties will be high frequency and low energy and plus noise. So high frequency, low energy plus noise, that will be available over here at receiver block. So now this property of signal that will get received by receiver block. Now once we receive that at receiver block, our basic agenda is to make that signal strong, and we need to extract that low frequency signal again. So in receiver block there will be demodulator which will be translating high frequency signal into low frequency signal, there will be amplifier that will be translating low energy signal into high energy signal, there will be filter that will remove noise. So there will be filter which will remove unwanted noise, and there are some other blocks even. So these are the blocks which will be there with receiver block, and obviously there will be antenna in case of wireless communication, there will be antenna over here. So after this receiver block, there will be demodulator which will be translating high frequency signal into low frequency signal, Amplifier will translate that weak signal into strong signal. Filter will translate, filter will remove that noise which is happening because of channel. So that many blocks are there. So here our signal will be now low frequency and high energy signal. So now our signal over here, that will be low frequency, high energy signal. Now there will be output transducer. That output transducer will convert electrical signal into non-electrical signal. Obviously over here this signal will be now electrical signal. Here we have received EM wave, and now that is what translated into electrical signal by this receiver block. Now output transducer, that will translate electrical signal into non-electrical signal. So this output transducer, it converts electrical signal into non-electrical signal. Like for example, if you have speaker, then electrical signal will be translated into voice. So for example, speaker. So that will translate electrical signal into voice and will be having output signal, which is input message signal. So this is what the complete process which happens in communication system. And in communication system engineering, I'll be explaining all those processes step by step in different units. So stay tuned with this channel. You'll be studying complete communication engineering. So it will give you understanding like how many things which is happening in communication engineering. And even you can suggest me those videos which is required to understand communication engineering. I'll place definitely videos based on your need to sort out those problems if I have understanding based on your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video. Keep watching, keep sharing with your friends.